Hello students, welcome to Kingdom of Learning, my educational channel. In this video, I'm going to explain chapter 2 of the novel The Invisible Man, that is a prescribed novel for class 12 CBSE. In the first chapter, I have explained till that point that Mrs. Hall, the innkeeper, she is very much surprised at the appearance of that strange person. She wants to know more about him. She wants to know why his whole face is covered with bandages. But when she asks him if he had met with an accident or something, that stranger, he does not show any interest in her queries. Means he is not interested in sharing anything with her. So now we will see chapter 2. When chapter 2 begins, it is shown that a visitor comes to the inn, coach and horses, and he is Teddy Hanfrey. He is from the same village and actually he is a clock mender. Clock mender means he does the work of repairing clocks. So now Mrs. Hall wants Hanfrey to fix a clock in the room of her guest, who is a very strange man. Actually, she wants to know more about that man. That's why she sends Teddy Hanfrey to remain in that room for some time and try to find out some secret. So now they both enter the room without knocking, and that is not liked by her guest, who is actually a scientist. So for a moment, Mrs. Hall thinks that the stranger has a giant mouth, but immediately the stranger covers his mouth. As soon as he finds that some people have entered the room, he covers his face again and then he becomes visible. Means whichsoever part of his body is not covered, that is invisible, and as soon as he covers it, that becomes visible. So that is the secret of that man, and Mrs. Hall doesn't know about that and she wants to know about that. Now the stranger tells Mrs. Hall that he would like to be left alone, because he tells her that he is an experimental investigator, which means he is a scientist and he is doing some research work that could be messed up by the people if they would go on entering his room whenever they want. Means the scientist is not at all interested that people should disturb him in his research work. So Mrs. Hall leaves the room of that stranger, but she leaves Teddy Hanfrey to fix the clock. Means the clock of that room is not working. So she asks Teddy Hanfrey to repair that clock. So now Hanfrey is also surprised to see at the stranger. He is also surprised to see why is he looking in that weird way. And intentionally, deliberately, he remains in the room of that stranger for a long time with the purpose of mending the clock, so that he can know something about that stranger. So now the stranger, the scientist, he comes to know about the intentions of that man, Teddy Hanfrey, and he also warns him to finish up his work quickly and get out of his room. So now Hanfrey is also very surprised. He wonders what is the secret of this man. Why is he covered so much like that? Why is he putting so many bandages on his face? He suspects him. He thinks that he might be a criminal. He might have committed some crime and is running away from the police. So with this suspicion, he leaves the room. Now he's going back to his home, and on the way he meets Mr. Hall, the husband of Mrs. Hall, the innkeeper, and he tells him about the entry of a weird guy staying at his inn. So till now Mr. Hall didn't know about the guest in his inn, but now he also gets suspicious after coming to know about that strange man from Teddy Hanfrey. So he is also a little drunk also at that time, because drinking alcohol is the hobby of Mr. Hall. So his wife tells him to mind his own business. means when he interrogates his wife about that stranger, she thinks that he is drunk, so he is just speaking unnecessarily, so she asks him to mind his own business. So although truth be told, Mrs. Hall herself is a little suspicious of the stranger. Means although she avoids her husband's questions, but she is also suspicious of that stranger. She also wants to know who he was and why was he looking like that and what experiment was he going to do. So in this way, chapter 2 comes to an end. So don't forget to subscribe the channel Kingdom of Learning. And if you want to read motivational and inspirational blogs, open the link provided in the description box. That is the link of my website, stiryoursoul.in. Thank you very much.